Welcome back, students, to the textile web processing to practicals. In today's practical, we are going to discuss about dyeing of polyester with dispersed dyes with carriers. In the previous lecture, we discussed about dyeing of polyester with dispersed dyes using HTHP dyeing machine. Today also we are going to use the same HTHP dyeing machine, but we are going to use a chemical called carriers. So what is meant by a carrier that we are going to see? See, normally the polyester dyeing can be performed by using four different methods. One method is dyeing you can do directly at boil without using carrier. That is possible to do, but you will not get the light shades or deep shades. You will get only the very pale shades. And another method is the HTHP machine, which we have already seen, where the regular dyeing you carry out at 130 degrees centigrade without using the carriers. And another method is the carrier method, which we are going to see today. So normally the dyeing of polyester is carried out using 130 degrees centigrade, okay? But when you use the chemical called carriers, you can reduce the temperature of usage of dyeing. For example, this carrier dyeing, it is performed at 100 degrees centigrade, but this is a boiling temperature. You see, this carrier is basically, these are made up of phenolic compounds and hydrocarbons. They actually swell the polyester fiber, okay? It creates some swelling, whichever is done by temperature, by swelling the pores, that is done by the chemical itself. So longitudinal swelling takes place when the carrier is used, so that you can reduce the temperature of dyeing. So with 100 degree itself, you can perform the dyeing. For this dyeing, as usual, you take the dispersed dyes of say 1% and 3%, two different shades I am taking today, and carrier of 1 gram per liter, dispersing agent of 1 gram per liter, acetic acid 2 grams per liter, pH around 5.5 to 6.5, temperature of say 100 degree centigrade, time 45 minutes. Okay, so this only difference in this thing is the temperature and the use of carrier. So coming down to calculation part, you see, for 1% shade, as usual, the formula is WP by C, weight of the fabric, multiplied by percentage that is required, divided by the stock solution percentage. I have prepared 1% stock, same dye I am using, that is the dispersed red dye. I am getting 2.425 ml. And carrier, it is available in the solution form. So the concentration is 1 gram per liter. So for 200 ml total volume of liquor, it is 0.2 gram is required, because for 1 gram per liter, for 200 ml means divided by 5, you will get 0.2 gram. Or you can say directly, if you want to take it in because it's in liquid form, so you can take 0.2 ml. Dispersing agent, same calculation, again 0.2 ml. Acetic acid for pH correction, because polyester, you know that polyester fabric, it is comfortable with acid, but it is not with the alkali. Alkali will degrade, so that is why the pH of the dyeing should be performed preferably from 5.5 to 6.5. So here acetic acid is taken little more, that is 2 GPL. So for accordingly, this will be around 4.4 ml for making the pH correction. And coming down to total volume of liquor, from 200 ml, how much water you need to subtract this with the dye solution. Even you can subtract this value also, but since assuming that the density is same, so very minute quantities we are taking, so I have not subtracted it. So the values are very less, so directly the water required is 197.5. if you subtract the total volume of liquor minus the dye solution. This is for 1% shade, but for 3% shade, calculation is same. Only thing is, in numerator, in the WP by C, I am using this 3, so it is 6.55 ml. You can see 3 times of this 1%. And water is, if you subtract from the total volume of liquor from the dye solution, you get 193.4 ml. Rest all axillaries, concentration and volume are going to be used the same. So this dyeing we are going to perform now. Already the dye beakers and dye solutions and other accessories are already prepared. So just we are going to start the dyeing. Just we will have the, you will see the practically how the dyeing is started. You can just have a look on it.